Hi, Happy New Year. Welcome to the year 2020. This week I want to be sharing with you about heaven's dew, because that's the word that God has given to us for this new year. That's the word He's given to me for the body of Christ, and I want to share that with you. It's powerful when God gives us a word. It's powerful when we hear God give us a direction, because when He speaks, He doesn't speak to describe, He speaks to change, and His word is like a roadmap to where we're going. And this year, God said to me to tell you that it's your year of heaven's dew. The Bible tells us in Genesis 27, from verse 27, this is when Jacob was blessed by his father Isaac, though he thought it was Esau. The Bible tells us that as he blessed him, the Bible says in verse 27, and he came near and kissed him, and he smelled the smell of his raiment and blessed him and said, see, the smell of my son is as the smell of a field which the Lord has blessed. Therefore, God give thee of the dew of heaven and the fatness of the earth and plenty of corn and wine. And there are some things I want you to note. Number one is that the blessing that came upon Jacob was as a result of a sacrifice he had brought to his father, prepared by his mother. In the same way, the blessing of the Lord that has come upon us is as a result of a sacrifice offered by God Himself in the person of Christ Jesus. God has blessed us not because of our background. He has blessed us not because of anything we've done. He has blessed us not because we have worked hard to deserve His blessing. We are blessed because God has prepared a sacrifice for us in the person of Christ. Now, what is it about this year? The Bible tells us that God said to Jacob that the smell of my son is like the smell of a field that the Lord has blessed. And that's the word God is speaking to you. Your field is blessed. Whatever you put your hands upon to do is blessed. As you go about your day, know that you are blessed. You are blessed because you have Christ as your sacrifice standing before the Father. But the word that God highlighted upon our spirit this year is what He says in verse 28, when He said, therefore, because your field is blessed, He said, therefore, the Lord give you the dew of heaven. Heaven's dew speaks about the favor of God, because the Bible tells us in the book of Proverbs chapter 19, in verse 12, He says that the wrath of a king, is like the anger, of a lion, the roaring of a lion. He says, but the favor, His favor, is like the dew upon the grass. That means the dew upon the grass is like the favor of God. What's the difference between the dew and the rain? The rain is conditional. The rain will come if the children of Israel kept the word. In scripture, we always see that every time people stayed with God's statutes, they obeyed God, the rain came. But the dew fell on a clear, calm land. It speaks about the unconditional favor of God, the unconditional love of God for us. Now, this is what I want you to know as you enter into the year 2020. That the blessing of the Lord is an empowerment that comes upon us, but the favor of God is the element of the blessing that creates opportunities for us. There are many people that are endowed, many people that are talented, many people with ideas, but lack opportunities. But what the dew does, what the favor of God does, is to create the necessary opportunities and platforms for you to be able to express the things that God has deposited in you. So as you go into this year, I want you to know that it's a great year. It's a beautiful year. And in this year, God is giving you mighty opportunities for expressions of the things that He has deposited on the inside of you. Never think that you are disadvantaged. You will see opportunities that only God can bring this year. So I want your hearts ready and expectant. I don't know about you, but I'm very, very expectant that God is giving me mighty supernatural opportunities for expressions of the blessing. Well, it's such an honor and a joy to be able to speak a word into your life. My name is Pastor Aaron Metokula, and I'm glad to bring you this word. Run with this word in the year 2020. Again, I say to you, Happy New Year.